I grew up in the co-regions of Pennsylvania. My father was an auto mechanic and mom was a nurse. My father was a musician. Keeping a long story very short, I think Dad's real passion in life was music. Dad also played in a local co-region band that read down charts for the Dorsey Brothers. When Tommy and Jimmy would come to visit their mother in Gilberton, it's my understanding that my father occasionally would be part of the group that would read down charts. He also taught my cousins, or helped my uncle start a band in the coal regions of my cousins. So there was always music around, but the coal regions, there was not means for me to even study piano. I mean, but it was always something. In high school, I played in the band. Then I went to Susquehanna University, and that's where the big change came. The change came because I was pre-med, and I wanted to do something musically. And I played clarinet in high school. And I would say borderline to badly. And I decided after 2 years or 2.5 years of pre-med, I want to be a music major. I had no right to do this at all. I didn't even know where middle C on the piano was. And I auditioned at Susquehanna University, which is where I was going to school, twice. The first time I didn't get in. And the chair of the music department at that time, who later became president of Muhlenberg College, came and told me the first time I wasn't good enough to get in. And that kind of annoyed me. So I practiced, I took the lightest course load, practiced 6 hours a day. And his name is Jim Steffi, and we're still very good friends. And he came and told me the second time, the second audition, he said, "It's not quite there yet, but we all think that there's something that's driving you and we want to give you a chance, but there's no guarantees here." So I started out at the bottom of the pile. I had a very passionate clarinet teacher who now in hindsight was kind of my spiritual mentor. He was patient. And then there was a choral conductor at Susquehanna by the name of Cyril Stratansky, and that's the first inkling that this is what I might want to do. The second inkling is very bizarre. Just after that, my wife and I were going to Sunbury, my wife-to-be now, Leslie, we went to Sunbury, Pennsylvania to a sub shop, and it's right across the street from Zion Lutheran Church. So we pick up our subs, and I'm walking, and I see a big placard. It says, "Concert Tonight, Luther College Choir, Weston Noble." Had no idea who that was. It says, "Choir, I think I like choir. I think I'll go." That was it. Done. Now, you understand I didn't sing in high school. I didn't sing in college till after this. So I'm going to be a choral. So then I decided I'm going to be a choral conductor. I auditioned for Bob Page at Temple. Not here at Westminster. I didn't even know about this place, frankly. But at the time, Temple was the program. So I figured, well, I'm going to get into the program. Bob accepted me. And I showed up to school. It's a true story. I'd never been to Philadelphia except for the auditions. I decided a couple days before I was going to grad school. I showed up and I said, "I'm here, can I see Mr. Page?" And they said, "Oh, he resigned." It's when Bob went to Carnegie Mellon. And I said, "Who did they hire?" He said, "Oh, they hired some old lady." And that old lady was Elaine Brown. And that is the change of my life. I talk about being in the right place at the right time, or that there's a plan. And from there, everything kind of, it was Elaine. If I didn't have Elaine, I wouldn't be doing any of this at all. And then secondarily, did my master's with Elaine, and then taught public school in Lewisburg, Pennsylvania, and wanted to do a doctorate. Felt I had a really good master's program. So then I heard Ed Gordon speak. And I thought, well, what I need as a conductor is learn how to teach better. So Ed advised me to do the PhD there in the psychology of music and go to Europe and study, which I did. I went and studied with Wilhelm Amon, and I met Frauke here, and then also in Europe, studied with her. So that's kind of the progression. Very bizarre. I have no right. And then how I got here, that's even a longer story, but